The Ember Spirit and the Timber Saw, which is probably the two best heroes in the game, versus the Terror Blade, and they ended up just like playing really well, and it worked out well for them here. And now they have played Secret before, and they have beat Secret before, so let's see if they can do it again.
Yeah, it's best of ones, though. It's always so hard, right? You mess up a little bit, and also, I imagine that Team Secret maybe won't be as confident as they were in the game that we had, where they beat Secret. Arteezy maybe overextended in a couple of places on that Timbersaw, and I feel like that really helped Escape get back into the game. But either way, we're through with the ban. They're getting rid of the Terror Blade, and of course Elder Titan for Poppy, and then everybody knows about Earth Spirit and the Dazzle. So.
Yeah, that's the basically the Escape Gaming specialty that we've seen throughout this qualifier. Dazzle on Cinderin, either Dazzle or Revenge on Cinderin for the most part, and then Yapzor plays a combination of like either the Earth Spirit, Earthshaker, and a few other different heroes, but that's pretty much their bread and butter, and that's what they've been winning with consistently. And yeah, Escape, of course, like you were saying, the other Titan ban, no shocker versus Puppy and versus Secret, just because they work really well around it, and the Terror Blade has just been coming into fruition heavily just from this tournament. And Secret does get their Darkseer that they've been heavily prioritizing for Bulba as well.
Yeah, everybody loving that Darkseer. For Escape, I wonder if they'll try to pick up for Kezu the Beast Monster, something they like, or also the Faceless Void. He's great on either of those, and always something reliable. Or instead, whether it'll be getting Quick for Tinker, because that may get banned out.
Yeah, usually they do like what? They started up with Venge Beastmaster a couple times when they've been on the Radiant.
There was one game where they did pick up both supports as well, and there was that odd, the IO game where they picked up, obviously not doable here since the Dazzle's banned out, but they had an IO Dazzle opener one time on Escape Gaming. So, yeah, lots of different options taking their time. And of course, this is really important. Escape Gaming can just win this one, get on through, get Cinder into another TI, but it's going to be the Venge you mentioned.
Yep.
I'm expecting Beastmaster. Could go for some other things.
Yep, maybe they can just change it up a little bit from what they've been doing, but that's pretty much the comfort that they've had, and like we were saying, Cinderin's pretty much exclusively playing Vengeful and Dazzle in this entire tournament.
Hey, if it works, don't fix it, right? So
exactly.
Don't have to go back to that lion and Timber instead.
So a bit of a change up there. That's a kind of a deny pick, I feel, but also, I mean, it's a super strong hero, even though Secret's been prioritizing it quite heavily. Usually in their first two picks, kind of been changing it a little bit just because of how prominent Terror Blade's been.
Yeah, I obviously Arteezy has played a lot of Timbersaw throughout these games. If we take a we're just taking a look. There was like three in a row with Timbersaw coming out there for Arteezy. So nice to Escape to have that. But I do wonder if they'll be as comfortable with it as Secret would be.
Yeah, they just played with it and it went swimmingly well, so we should be able to do it again. And they go for the Axe very early on Team Secret, so pure damage to be able to go through the Timber Saw. It's quite nice. Of course, you don't have to worry about the reactive armor. And Berserker Call is a reliable lockdown, as well as just the combination. This is something that Secret's been doing pretty consistently. When they have the Darkseer, they pick Puppy up on one of those like dual laner type heroes. He goes for this greedy type thing and he just farms, and he's able to contribute a lot into the game once he gets his level like 5 or level 6. We tend to see them make that smoke rotation toward Bulba's lane, toward the Darkseer's lane, take the Ion Shell and a surged up Axe, and you can pretty much find kills on anybody with that combo.
Didn't they run the Axe against Escape and not succeed terribly well? Am I thinking of the wrong match? We've had a long day. Let's double check over.
You might be right. I feel like it happened, but
who knows, guys? We've had so many games here. But yeah, I'm a little surprised to see it come out again. Escape now also, as you said, get an opportunity to draft around making sure that they can match out this greedy lineup. It's going to be the Koik for Tinker ban out, though.
Yeah, they've picked the Axe with the Darkseer two times. The last time was the last game versus Empire now. That they played, and then the one earlier was versus Alliance.
Yeah, and they did do, it was that Axe anti-mage game versus Escape where the Morphling was 17-0.
Oh, yes.
So
that's,
that was the Axe that didn't work so well, so I'm a little surprised they come out with it again, but maybe feeling incredibly comfortable with it.
Yeah, just, I mean, Puppy's really been liking the hero. Overall, pure damage is very nice. The buffs, as well as Blade Mail, can be extremely devastating. Even versus Timbersaw, if he doesn't get, I mean, if he gets If his spells catch on the Axe from Blade Mail, he can actually burst himself down quite quickly. And other than that, looking at the bans, not too many shockers coming out. The Slark ban is a little bit odd, I guess, from Escape, but they just don't want to play against it. It's not really one, something that Secret runs too often, though.
The Tinker ban out means that Secret don't think this is mid-Timbersaw.
Yes.
So that's kind of a little bit of an interesting one. It's going to get rid of the Shadow Demon. This is something else Secret played up against them. They opened, I believe, with Shadow Demon when they played up against Escape. So it's kind of interesting there.
Yeah, Shadow Demon gives you a lot of setup. It's also just a comfort hero for Secret, it seems. Pi's been playing it a lot, and the hero's just been gaining more popularity, especially because of just illusion-based heroes and how much Disruption's been buffed over the last couple patches.
Yeah, so we'll have to wait on this next one. They are taking ages on this draft. Obviously, a lot is on the line here. But anyway, what do you think about that? Do you think it's not going to be the mid-Timber? It's kind of weird, because that's where we've been seeing folks play it. You can try for it in the off lane, but, or the safe lane. We've seen that a few times. Ramses used to run that.
I think it's probably going to be the mid-Timber. I mean, they just played it as well on Koi.
Yeah,
Club,
that's
so.
Why I'm so now an Alk ban out, too.
Hmm. I guess maybe those are heroes that they just don't want to deal with anyway. Maybe they don't really care if the Timber's mid. Maybe they're just trying to play mind games with their enemy.
Certainly catching us. Well, Escape, they'll get to pick up something here. Show it off, and I wonder if they're going to go for something just pretty standard like they've been doing with Aerith. They can always go for Jug. That's a pretty solid carry. They picked him a lot of Sven this tournament, or whether it's going to be the Morphling, which they did use to dominate Secret. It's hard to tell yet if that's going to be viable for them.
They go for the safe pick for Yapzor. He's been playing. He's one of the few people who's actually been playing the Earthshaker still. Air Spirit's banned out, and he just seems to be really be prioritizing it. It's really good to mess up the synergy from a lineup. Like, if you're positioned properly as an Earthshaker, of course, an Echo Slam can really devastate a lineup or a proper initiation, but even just a nice Fissure to mess up a combo can be quite good. And it also gives him a lot of teamfight here. A lot of lockdown, a lot of teamfight. That's pretty much what Earthshaker does if you can have him reliably make it through that early game.
Yeah, Secret, I mean, are there particularly great answers to an Earthshaker as a support hero? It doesn't. Obviously, he's someone who can get, can block off a lot of things, can really set up those ganks, especially paired with Avenge.
Yeah, you probably don't really want to think about the specific Earthshaker in that manner, just because, you know, it's a support. You know, it's there. Just think about it, keep in the back of your mind. But you don't really want to draft so much around it. Like, you're obviously not going to pick a bunch of illusion heroes or anything into an Earthshaker.
So, for, let's see, what else have Secret decided that was super priority for them? They. Okay, we're doing carry Faceless Void from the looks of things.
And they have not ran that at all. So it's a big change-up that they're doing with their draft right now.
Well, that could explain some of those bans, right? I'm not super sure. We're currently, guys, we're checking over a lot more of Secret's history, trying to get it.
I was thinking that I just... Of course, like, we've been doing so many games. I felt like I'd seen them play it, but it was a different team that ended up running it with the Darkseer.
Yes, Secret have been picking up Slaughter a lot more. Obviously, sometimes Darkseer is banned out there instead, and stuff like Enchantress of Puppy, although he's filling that axe role here. So I'm the Faceless Void, obviously, with the Darkseer to help out. Throw the Ion Shell on you. You can get some good early damage into the Chronosphere.
Yeah, big combos as well. You can obviously vacuum people into the Chronosphere later on in the stages of the game, but also Void just versus these three heroes. These are heroes with kind of low cooldown spells for the most part. I mean, of course, Fissure and the Magic Missile, or Fissure and Wave of Terror are actually having like two of the longer cooldowns, but Time Dilation into Timbersaw is extremely devastating because it, of course, puts all of his spells on cooldown for a very long time, and it's the same kind of thing versus the Earthshaker, so it's a really interesting pickup, and it's also a hero that, you know, of course, Time Walk can evade a lot of damage, especially if you don't lock him down properly. And Escape goes back for their Beastmaster, which they've been doing pretty consistently, but this time they opted to save it for the fourth pick rather than the second pick.
Yeah, I mean, if you can get it that far into the draft, right, deny the Timbersaw, and Secret still not banning out Kezu's Beastmaster, I think you're very happy with that. So, gonna give them as well a lot of good vision to hopefully see the Faceless Void or the Axe coming with the Blinks using that Hawk.
Yeah, so. And this is probably where they pick up Pi's hero, just to save the rest of it. And they were looking at a lot of Winter Wyvern just because the combo with Dark Spirit. No, I'm kidding. They end up actually going for Death Prophet. They obviously know that the Timbersaw now is pretty much guaranteed to be mid. They still could even safe lane it, I guess, but then they don't really have a carry to even up their lineup. So Death Prophet picked up. It's objective taker. All three heroes that they have on Team Secret before the Death Prophet aren't really tower hitters by any means. They're not really objective takers either. They're just kind of like these team fight champions. Of like obviously champions of team fight, and yeah, Death Prophet gives them a lot more and just kind of brings their lineup together.
Yeah, certainly someone who's a pain in the ass to Timpasaur in the mid lane, right? I've been seeing Death Prophet bans all the time. Witch Doctor, they're banning that out by Escape, getting rid of one of the good sustain heroes left in the game. And also, sometimes can be a pain against the Beastmaster, because you can get the paralyzing cost bouncing between you and your boar. Suddenly you're dead in lane, so...
Yeah, it's just a safe hero that Secret has ran a couple of times on Pi, but for the most part he's played the Venge, the Shadow Demon, the Lion...
I mean,
and the Witch Doctor.
Also, yeah, has there been some Rubick coming out of Team Secret?
Just like one or two, not really too often. They ban
the
Morph, and this is probably the Lion, just because it's, I mean, one of Pi's signature heroes. It is good with the Darksteer to get more wombo combo. It's a strong support for the lane, and it gives them a bit more disable, which they are kind of lacking at this moment in time.
Yeah, makes a lot of sense into Timbersaur and so on too. So, yeah, the Morphling ban, of course, because of that 17-0 game. And also because Team Secret, I mean...
So they do go for the Wyvern anyway, just to make that wombo combo. And it's, of course, the Cold Embrace with the Death Prophet and the Cold Embrace with the Axe. That's actually something that we saw... Complexity do at Epicenter. They did that combo with the jungle Axe Winter Wyvern, and the Axe was like super farmed because of it. And Escape Gaming goes for a Wraith King last pick.
So my only concern with Secret's draft is a lot of their ultimates are pretty long cooldown. If they end up blowing, let's say, Chronosphere and Exorcism in a fight, and Escape Gaming are able to back out and wait them out, you know, they can re-engage.
They do have a lot of kite potential to just like dance around the Wraith King for a while. And they have a lot of different types of... Like, they have the Silence up on the Death Prophet. They have the Time Dilation, as I was mentioning earlier, for the Void. On the Void for the Timbersaw. So it's a pretty interesting draft. It's quite a change-up for Escape 2, picking that Wraith King.
Yeah, I like seeing this adaption, right? Generally, during both the Open Qualifiers and the Regionals, we see teams adapting, learning each other's ways. Obviously, Ad Finem started picking up stuff like the Elder Titan, Escape Gaming 2, adjusting to the fact that Secret was using him so effectively. And so here, we'll see that Era is going to be playing Wraith King. It's not like he hasn't played Wraith King before, but...
Yeah, I'm still a little bit worried for Escape, just because their lineup looks a little bit strange. Just having this... very single target heavy Wraith King, but I can understand it's something that people used to do a while ago. It's when people picked Void, they would basically pick Wraith King as a response. So I guess that's along the lines of what they're looking at, and also yeah, I guess he just can kind of like deal with the Darkseer a little bit in the laning phase. They have multiple amounts of stun now. They have the tri-stun in their defensive tri-lane.
There's going to be a lot on the back of Koikva for that AoE damage you mentioned, if you want to get more done, but they do have, you know, you mentioned single target, you've got Primal Roar, you've got Magic Missile, Wraith Fire Blast. You should, when they get to the point of the game where maybe they're smoking or they're looking for pickoffs, it should be very easy for them. There's already Fissure action happening, actually. Pileidai takes one of those to the face.
Yep, so our scouts him out. It looked like Pi was trying to actually get a nice ward up there to block the Beastmaster's camp, but unable to do so from the movement from Yapzor. And Secret doing something that they've been doing quite a lot, a ward to block the pull from the side of Escape, as well as a vision ward in the enemy jungle.
Yeah, and let's do some quick player introductions for those of you who may be new around here. We've got Sindarin playing up that Vengeful Spirit, Era playing Wraith King, Timbersaw, not Terrorblade, seeing a lot of that guy, but this is going to be Timbersaw played by Koikva, Earthshaker finally getting out of the base being played by Yapzor, and of course Kazu on his signature Beastmaster, tossing it over to you for Team Secret.
Yep, for Secret we have Puppy, of course, playing the Axe, which he has been playing a lot recently, Envy playing the Death Prophet, so a bit of a change-up. They have Envy playing the mid again for that Death Prophet. Darkseer being controlled up by Bulba himself. He has some very heavy laning items, so it looks like they're going to be going for a straight-up dual lane with the Axe and the Darkseer. And then we have Winter Wyvern, of course, played by Pileidai, who actually is... Ooh, am I going to get a kill of a Hawk here? Nope, it doesn't. But last but not least, Arteezy, of course, playing the safe lane carry Void.
Now, They will have him eventually getting support of the Wyvern coming up here, but for now, Kazu might be able to get a little bit of experience. We'll check back in this mid lane. We talked about it some in the draft. Death Prophet, she's got that Spirit Siphon, which can help her against the Timpasaur, right? How do you expect it to go down? Oh, did you?
You're getting a bit of a lag spike, yeah. It should be fine, just quite a bit more bottom lane. Seeing a little bit of action happening, just some stuns coming out. This is going to be a really disruptive lane. This Axe Darkseer is going to mess so much with this Wraith King and this Avenger Shaker. They can't leave the Wraith King alone, and that's, I feel like it's going to heavily hurt them because their pull is blocked, so they can't even get that extra experience in the lane at all for the supports or for the Wraith King on the side of Escape.
Yeah, it's a really good job of making sure, obviously with Death Prophet, you can bring her down if you had, for example, the Vend and the Earthshaker rotating, especially with Timbersaw's burst, but they're stuck down here with Era, and we'll see if they manage to... Oh, they just missed the ward.
Top lane now, Kezu actually getting chased down.
Now we'll see the Arctic Burn. Oh, he's just going to go for the TP unless they get the bash. Nope. No. Arteezy, no RNG.
Nope. And going back to the mid lane like you were asking, they should be able to just free farm both of them across the board. The Death Prophet may be able to be able to pressure the Timbersaw a bit, but it's pretty much you want to just get your last hit, so you don't want to pressure him too much and mess up your own CS, because level 2 reactive armor is pretty absurd. As long as he keeps the stacks up, it's going to be really hard for Envy to actually harass him properly.
We can see already maxed out on there. Envy trying with the auto attacks and the Crypt Swarm barely doing anything. Well, Puppy hasn't put level 2 into any of the skill points, but of course is harassing with that battle hunger. We've seen this before. Sometimes Puppy also, he's actually not headed off at all, as you talked about, to the jungle, just to make sure the supports stay down.
Yeah, that's pretty much all they're accomplishing. They're accomplishing everything they need to, and they did not even find the D ward with the ward from Cinderin, so that's really, really hurtful. Like I said, they're pretty much straight up tri-laning, so they're going to be getting a lot less XP compared to the Darkseer and the Axe, and it forces the supports to stay there, like we were mentioning. And then Envy, of course, going back to that mid lane, he just picked up a regen from top lane, so that really, really is going to help him out a lot.
Okey-dokes, and okay. Well, sorry guys, we were having a little tech issue. There we go, again, Puppy aggressing up. They're just this Ion Shell being a real pain, and maybe when they get more levels like you mentioned, they can do something down here, but for now it doesn't feel like this tri-lane can be terribly aggressive. Of course, once they do get some levels, maybe level 3 on each of them, they could probably get a kill onto Bulbul or Puppy.
Yeah, no, absolutely. They just have to be really keen on the way they do their positioning with the Fissure.
Nope. Never mind, just off the mark. Yapzor not showing off that signature business yet. While Kezu gets a little bit of harass out onto Pylai Dai, who is trying to stop him from using this hard camp. It's of course now being warded, so Kezu gonna have a fun time trying to jungle.
Yeah, and they just pretty much use that Fissure and that Wave of Terror there to stop Bulba's Clarity. The way that they can actually make aggressive plays in this lane is once Bulba's out of mana, which he kind of is right now, and they don't have Ion Shells, but Soul Ring Recipe gets delivered, and he's gonna finish that up and have plenty of Ion Shells for himself. Puppy trying to go for the rune here. He gets the Battle Hunger actually on Yapzor, and he's gonna run at him.
Yeah, he's pretty low. A nice stun coming out from Cinderin. It's not like Puppy has too much else. Let's see what the rune is. Yapzor will just pick up the bounty and clarity. He'll get to keep that on him. While at the top rune, again! Oh, Eternal Envy trying to make Koipa leave him alone, and didn't see who got that one. Oh, both going the way of Escape.
Yeah, Beastmaster grabbed an invis there. And he's able to get a little bit of jungling done. That camp is actually going to be blocked after that, after he finishes clearing it, though.
I believe he realized that occurred, right? Because he saw Pylai Dai come right on up.
Yeah.
For Kezu, abandoning the lane, going over to the jungle, do you think that's the best bet up against this Faceless Void Wyvern?
Yeah, he's already kind of attempted to disrupt them, and it's not worked, so...
Oh, they're going on to Puppy here. Oh my goodness, with that next stun, it looks like this should be our first bloody con escape. He's healing up a little bit from the tree.
Oh my god.
Okay, no, the Wraithfire Blast. One more hit. Yes, they get the first blood.
If he had lived there, that would have been such a sick play. Bulba and they both used their salves on him to try to save him up, but very nice Fissure coming out from Yapzor, finding the opportunity and taking it with a great Fissure block. But yeah, the Beastmaster, you should just pretty much go to the jungle. You farm so quickly in the jungle as a Beastmaster, and you're not really pressuring the Void at all, as you can see. I mean, Arteezy has pretty much perfect CS.
Yeah.
Almost 8 CS per minute.
Obviously, in this bottom lane, if they can continue to do that, Applying pressure. Yeah, I'm actually gonna go head out home. Surprised he doesn't buy out in suicide. That's because he's so close to those arcanes right
He's
there.
rich.
Yeah. Wow, good job, Yapzor. So, and so is Era, already finishing up those treads. Never mind. This bottom lane, suddenly going a little bit better.
How is he so rich, actually? Did he must have stolen some big creeps.
So, I think when this occurred, the fissure, there was the Dire creeps, and also, as you said, the Hard Camp creeps.
Yeah, because he only has 3 CS, but he has an enormous amount of money.
Yeah. Hey, it's Yapzor. He does things that the rest of us can't.
Yeah,
so.
That's actually really impressive.
Yeah, he'll come in onto mid, see what he can make happen. Hasn't been spotted here yet due to it being nighttime. So, and do you think it's worth it? Obviously, it's very difficult to justify leaving Era alone, but if Syndra and Yapzor could get a kill on the Death Prophet mid, would it be worth it?
I mean,
sorry, come leave Era. What?
You said Syndra and Yapzor are getting a kill on mid. Alright, Quakefoot and. Yeah, I was just confused. Quakefoot and Yapzor, yeah, I think it's worth it, but you don't want to stay there too long. You don't want to just like sit there waiting for the opportunity. Just if it comes to you, you can do it, but otherwise you should just be playing around bottom. And you want to pick up your arcane boots from down there anyway, so.
Yeah. Could go for just a little bit
again,
more sniping, yeah.
Puppy might actually be able to get Fissure blocked here. They are pinging him out, they see this. Yapzor is level 4.
And Syndra, oh, Era. Actually, Syndra's gonna open this. Puppy suddenly with a lot of. Oh
nice
my
block.
Goodness. Welcome to Yapzor. There'll be the Cold Embrace, though. A nice job by Pylai Dai. And now they're backing out. Envy coming down as well. Spirit Siphon's gonna be going on to Syndra and Era with the Battle Hunger. He is slowed up. They're chasing him down. And Era, oh, will he just. A beautiful fissure from Yapzor. And Era's gonna be able to walk it on off. He's stuck under the tower in a bad spot. And of course, Syndra does end up going down. Wow, Envy popped the Exorcism for that.
Yeah, he just wanted to make sure he got at least one of the kills after they realized that the Wraithing's actually getting away.
Yeah.
I liked what Envy was doing, going for both kills, but ends up not really working out for him because they don't get the Wraith King. He went for the double Spirit Siphon and then he chased out the Venge, thinking his team would be able to clean up Era, but either way, it works out for them. It's pretty much like they killed him anyway because he's just sitting in the trees, unable to escape. He's got to cut a path all the way to be able to cut it and buy a TP.
I don't know if they realize that he's there. They're actually going to check it out, see if they can find Yapzor, but otherwise it should be the first tower down, and this is really nice, getting the safe lane tower down so quickly.
Yep, and Kizu sees the opportunity. He goes top.
Yeah, we could actually see Yapzor writing on the map that that's what they needed to do, but Faceless Void will destroy that tower down in bottom. Wraith King still wasting all of this time trying to cut a path to freedom. Managed to pick up a TP, actually TPing right next to Envy.
Yeah, this is kind of the standard for Dire. The people we've been talking about a lot is around that like 8 to 13 minute mark. You want to be able to get into the Radiant short lane, take the tower, get some wards aggressively into the enemy jungle just so you can see what's going on, who's farming where, and where the rotations are coming from that. So it's good that they have that. Yapzor finishes up his Arcane Boots as well for escape. Nicely timed.
And on Secret, they're looking to go push top. They don't have Exorcism up, but Envy has some illusions, and with this huge influx of gold, if they can also get this tier 1, Escape are going to be playing from behind for a little bit here.
Yeah, and Escape doesn't really have great tower hitters. Like, sure, they have the Beastmaster aura and the Venge aura to pump somebody up, but Wraith King overall as a tower hitter, he's not really the greatest, because he's a melee hero, and him in the front line, sure, he's super tanky, and he has his reincarnation when he is level 6 and everything, but he is not one of those like straight up sieges by any means.
Oh, Fissure onto Puppy, doesn't quite block Syndra. I'm trying to just give him the harass, but they'll have to go back over to the tower. This is actually in deny range, so this is fantastic for Escape. Unfortunately, you lose the tower, but of course, denying it, a big win.
Yep. And that those type of towers, it's just like, it's whatever when you lose them. It's gonna inevitably happen. Maybe you don't want it to happen this early to lose two towers, but either way, what can you do?
Yeah, especially against a Death Prophet. So for Era, it does feel like Escape need to make sure that this jungle is safe for him to farm. What else can they do? Because he isn't the fastest farmer on the Wraith King. Doesn't naturally have any way of quickly clearing the creeps, although the Vampiric Aura does help you sustain.
Well, he's doing the build that helps you actually jungle faster, because they did change the way Mortal Strike works on non-hero units, so he gets the 500% critical, which he is deciding to max for. So he does have that small acceleration at least from that, and Syndra does actually finds the D ward in their own jungle, so Secret's not going to be aware of everything that's going on in there anymore.
Yeah, that's actually really big, finding that D ward. It as you talked about, you get down one of those the tier one in bottom or the tier one in mid, and you ward up your opponent's jungle. And so being unable to have that up, that vision, just makes it very hard to smoke gank in there and get work done.
Yep, and it looks like this is the timing now to make another move with the axe, with Puppy. He's got his tranquil boots and his raindrops up, and he buys a smoke for himself. So he's ready to make moves with his fresh level 6, his fresh culling blade, his decapitate.
Yeah. A little bit slower than in the last game we saw, where Puppy, of course, when he was dedicatedly jungling, got 6 very early. But going to be able to make it work up. Casual fissure onto Envy. I believe that's because, yeah, Earthshaker has mana boots, so not too worried about it. And it looks like they're gearing up for a defensive mid on Escape, or at least worried that, of course, being the last team on tower, it's going to get pushed down.
Yeah, and Arteezy's going for that the aura build, so he goes for the Vlad's, disassembles his Ring of Akilah for that.
Yeah. Meanwhile, Era just continuing to farm, as you said, working on the omelet. How involved should he be in these fights upcoming?
Oh, excuse me, sorry.
Do you recommend that Era, we've seen a couple games where he just kind of ignores the rest of the events and farms. Do you recommend here on the Wraith King that he comes in? Because there's going to be a push at some point, and it's always hard to fight into the exorcism. So would his time better be spent trying to help burst down that Eternal Envy or farm elsewhere?
For now, just farm, because his team looks like they're going to be making the move away from him as well. So he's not even going to be able to help them at this current moment in time. And it looks like Secret are going to go for the Roshan here. So if they take the Rosh, then Era's going to have to go for farming for quite a while.
Yeah, they're sitting outside, making sure they get a ward down, as you said, before they take it. Exorcism will come on out here, and Arteezy will tank for a little bit.
They're pinging it out right away.
Oh yeah, the scan, is it going to catch anyone? Yes, it is. They're going to quickly head on over. There's two of them. The Exorcism is going. Era's going to be leading the charge. Spirit Siphon coming out onto him. The Battle Hunger as well. Era very slow here. Quick, but trying to help him out with the Chakram. Era, you're going to be burning that Reincarnate here, and Exorcism will help bring him down, but a Timber Chain through onto Arteezy. He still has that Time Warp. Drops the Chronosphere right onto Era's head, while Envy is there as well. A Timber Chain through onto Arteezy with the Whirling Death, getting the kill there. Era will fall here, but Puppy on the sidelines, cold embraced up, and it is so far carry for carry. Let's see if Secret can find anything else with the exorcism over. It might be hard, quick, but jumping in a beautiful Fizzer Bulba Echo Slam down there. And now Yapzor trying to wander around the wall. It looks like this should be the end of the engagement.
Yeah, Koikpa was a little bit low on mana, but that's actually super impressive that they noticed in time to be able to get there and disrupt the rush. That is a big deal. Era drops twice, but absolutely worth it. You know, Timbersaw cleans up a bit amount of the kills. Even though he was running low on mana, he gets what he needs to. He kills Arteezy too, but...
Yeah, so core for core, and then of course having the follow-up of the Darkseer seems very good in my book. Actually putting the Tome of Knowledge onto the Death Prophet here, wanting to make sure that Envy getting pretty far ahead. If you're Secret here, do you worry at all that you haven't taken this mid T1 yet, just because it is, you know, you used Exorcism, attempted on the Roche, didn't quite work out, you're gonna have to wait for the next one?
Maybe they're realizing now that it was a little bit rushed, because going for that Roche, they have to sneak it, and having that tier 1 so close to that Roche pit from Radiant is detrimental for them for sure. So now they probably aren't worried, but now with this Arcane Rune being picked up on Envy, we'll probably see that tier 1 mid get pushed with the next Exorcism. And they actually are also stacking up Ancients this entire time for the Axe.
Yeah, that's a really nice thing there. We don't always see that, but of course getting that Blink Dagger up quickly onto Puppy or Blade Mail, right? Gonna do a lot of work.
Yeah, eventually we'll definitely see we should definitely see the Blade Mail coming out for him and probably the Wraith King.
So, meanwhile, Era continuing to try to farm up a storm. Do you think that this is one of the games where he should go for Blink or another defensive item? Because he is fighting into a lot of damage.
I'm taking a look at how close. He might be able to wait and just see how the game is feeling out if he needs to go for that Blink, because Yapzor is already like 800 gold away from a Blink Dagger. And Kezu is, if he wants to, pretty like on his way to one as well. So maybe he's just gonna probably just feel out the scenario of how the game's going and then make his decision based off that. I think Blade Mail is a pretty decent choice overall, but I think Blink Dagger eventually he should definitely pick it up, just because, of course, the natural badness of Wraith King, how he gets kited quite easily.
Yeah, also being able to follow Yapzor in, or the Timbersaw, since of course Timbersaw will be chaining around Actually, I have Sindarin. Is he placing a ward? He's chillaxing. So, nice synergy as well there with the cold embrace onto Puppy so he can still get the spin.
He's actually,
is he leeching?
Leeching, yeah. The ancient experience there, yeah.
Well, good job. Good job, Sindarin. I was just expecting him to place his ward, but they do already have a close one. Taking a look at Radiant Vision, they are ready to siege this tower, but I'm not sure that they have the right click.
Yeah, and it does look like Era is going to be going for the blade mail. He picks up the broadsword, and he's got his level 11 now, and reincarnates up in 50 seconds. So they can look to try to start actually like being the aggressors pretty soon, just for a little bit.
Yeah.
But probably if as soon as they spot out that arcane rune on Envy and his level 11, they should probably be careful. And let's see the secret go back to try for the Roshan again.
Going to be in for an awful surprise. Yeah, there's a.
Yep, they're going for it again.
And there's a Hawk right on top of it. So, yep, the Hawk will get blown up, but now they know. Envy knows as well, though. They want to get this because we talked about if they miss out on it again, another exorcism, that's waiting quite a while for the next one.
Well,
but
it's an arcane rune exorcism, though, so it isn't that long, actually, thankfully, for them.
Oh, but it looks like they will get the Roshan. We'll see if they can come in and contest on escape. If they can't contest, it feels like they need to get as far away as possible and wait it out.
Oh, two-man call for Puppy.
Oh, no. Puppy, and there's going to be the Chronosphere coming out here. Oh, geez, he doesn't even need it. They just blow them up with the vacuum. And that's what we were talking about. Support's gone in the blink of an eye.
Yep. Kind of lingering a bit too long. They really wanted to try to do something into that Rosh pit there, but there's no way. Like, Era wasn't even there. Kezu's farming neutrals, and Koifa was pressuring the mid tower, so maybe again, like we were seeing in one of the games earlier, a little bit of miscommunication coming out from Escape. The supports looked like they wanted to contest, but the cores did not seem to have an interest in doing that at all.
Yeah. On the upside for Escape, if they can draw attention elsewhere, or if Secret all group up as five to push a tower, you can get some returned push using the Beastmaster, especially once you have Necronomicon's level 3. But otherwise, it does feel like they may have to, on Escape, sit back for a little while and let themselves be pushed. Otherwise, they have to fight into Exorcism, but also an Aegis on Faceless Void.
Yep. They gotta be a little bit careful for now. They are close to their book 3 on Kezu. They are close to a bunch of different little items that'll help them out a lot. Like the Blink on the Earthshaker as well. And then Kezu, obviously, his Blink Dagger after that book 3, which is coming out now. And they have the Bloodstone on Koifa and an Arcane Rune. So that could be the signal to go for maybe a gank, but not a big team fight, because there's no way that they can take a big team fight into Secret when they have Exorcism, and they have Chrono, when they have all their ultimates up.
So they smoke up here, but Yapzo only 300 gold away from the Blink. We'll see if they can find something and finish that off for him. They actually back on out, seeing Arteezy there. Not a very easy kill, but may have to end up going for it.
Kazu gets walks up the hill. Does he get high? Nope.
He won't be able to. Does break the smoke. Maybe they can bait them on some. Oh, okay. Arteezy can easily jump over that fissure. He is trying to get over to Kezu, but instead they'll just kill off the Necro Creeps. A big old zap going on to Arteezy, who immediately time walks it off, and that's the failed smoke immediately. The lack of initiation there.
That's a fresh book 3 too. One of the first book usages of the game by him, and it is foiled. So now Secret sees their window, and they're going to go for that mid-tower, not even expending the Exorcism for this one.
Yeah, they can save it for the Tier 2. It's looking a bit hard right now for Escape, obviously wanting to wait out that Aegis. It has another 2.5 minutes, though, and yeah, that's easily the Tier 2 in this lane as well, if Secret are so inclined.
They're still doing a good job of distributing the resources among all their heroes, like we've been commenting about Yapzor. He's close to that Blink Dagger. Everybody else have their items that they need for the most part. It's just fighting into Secret is just super difficult with all the ultimates that they have.
The last tiebreaker match, along with this one, have been very slow when it comes to kills. What is it about the current meta, the heroes that are strong, that's really forcing that? Because it feels like both teams, in a lot of cases, content to either sit back and farm. We've had that in a few games, like the AM versus the Morphling one. And other times, it's just you're dodging Death Prophet or someone similar, like the Tide.
A lot on the line. Both teams, they're all just playing super safe. Arteezy gets a jump off. Chrono, Sindarin alone.
Oh yeah, they're going on the top lane, but I'm not sure. Oh, he does manage to bring down on Cinder, and at the same time, Eret is up there, tries to turn it around and go for the TP away. They won't get the bash. Meanwhile, on the bottom lane, Death Prophet gets one kill. Kezu in trouble as well. Death Prophet can reach up. She has a Spirit Siphon. She's going to use it. Kezu slowed down. Brought the Echo Slam, but Yapsol, there's no follow-up damage. He's barely even going to save the tower here, and... oh, maybe the Necronomicon creep can be the hero. Beastmaster does get the deny with it, trying to use the Ion Shell to burn down the Necronomicon, but instead, Envy will eat it. I mean, hey, he saved Bulba, kind of, not really.
Hey, 200 gold, right?
Yeah, good stuff. Min-maxing. The fight's going wrong everywhere for Escape.
Yeah, they, like we're saying, they can't take the fights into secret when all the ultimates are up. Even if they're all, like, split up like that, it's very hard for them because on top of all the massive teamfight ultimates, they even have a mech, which is going to burst their teamfight even more so. And they have the Vlads on Arteezy, even though he was completely split out of that one. And Artur finishes up his Manta style as well now. So he's going to start dishing out a good amount of damage. And he's going to be able to disjoint all the different stuns. And
Additionally, Escape, they put these two wards up when they were playing up there with Cinderin and Era. And they're not super effective in making sure that their jungle is uncontested. Amusingly, they were trying to use Cinder in the same way they have been all tournament, having him stand behind Era, ready to swap. But since Arteezy jumped Cinder and wasn't able to save, or wasn't able to utilize that hero that way.
Yep.
So, but we do have the Blink Dagger up on Wraith King. That's something.
And we have the stat build. So 2-1-4 and all out stats.
So you really think it's just that there's a lot on the line, that both teams are playing so cautiously? You don't think we're seeing some better understanding of the patch or so on?
Could be a little bit of both, but probably more so people just being patient. It's like we've been saying, it's a lot on the line. This is the decider to see who goes.
Is this a, do you think, an indication of what TI might look like?
Some games.
Oh.
Probably some games.
Well, I'm hopeful we get some of the more crazy kill-heavy games we've seen throughout these qualifiers than all these cautious ones. Although it's still good Dota, but obviously a little bit slower than we might, some of us bloodthirsty people may like.
Yeah, both teams are just like sitting back and farming, honestly. Yeah. 3-7. It's pretty similar in the last series, or in the last game that we just saw. It was like, the score was like 4-2 one point, and then within 5 minutes it was like 17-12 or something. So we'll probably see that same type of explosion happen in this game unless one team just makes really big mistakes.
Unfortunately, I remember that explosion happened around like the 30-minute mark from what we saw over there hanging out in the casual area of the
ultimate's
hub.
Ready. Secret smokes up.
Yeah, they have a little bit of a lead. It's actually not too huge, 20 minutes in, but it's just something where we can see that Escape are falling behind, and they are also smoked up and ready. Yapsol leading the charge. We'll see if he can get something. He does have Echo Slam at the ready. Smokes will be breaking. Era just hanging out, showing himself. Gonna act like there's nothing going on there. Here comes Puppy. There it is. The Cole coming out, pulling Era forwards. He has a lot of backup here. Will they be able to go? It's actually gonna be Primal Roar onto Envy, but she's got a BKB there and the Exorcism. Era needs to get out of town. A beautiful stun by Yapsol should be able to get them all away. And if they can wait out this Exorcism with BKB also down, maybe they can re-goose on Escape. Oh, Envy actually taking a lot of damage.
Yeah,
we hear another
grabbed.
Pull. Oh no, he's getting pulled up, but he's gonna be just fine. They still have the Echo Slam. It could a fissure instead. Gonna be what goes up there. The Echo Slam follow up. They've got the Timber Chakram going through and the chain, and they get a two quick picks on the cause. Bulba now being body blocked up here by Koik, but not gonna just let him go free. Yapsol looking for the stun. A vacuum back by Bulba, but there are too many single target stuns, and he will go down. Escape Gaming fighting back.
You know, that was a great Echo Slam and everything by Yapsor, but Cinderin is the only reason that actually happened. So I know people are going to look at this and be like, wow, Yapsor just did an incredible Echo Slam, great like play by him. But Cinderin, since Yapsor got on by Puppy, the Axe, Cinderin actually turned and swapped Arteezy and stunned him before Artur was able to jump in and get the chrono on top of Yapsor. So huge heads up play there by Cinderin and enabling Yapsor to get that beautiful Echo Slam and follow up to clear out those heroes.
Yeah, these guys are clearly working together a lot better in the game than we just saw, but also just throughout this regional qualifier. Oh, they're not done yet. They're going to stun up. Pylai Dai has that Cold Embrace though, and Puppy going to just draw some attention away, but here comes the Timber. Pure damage. No, they're actually going to force him to fight onto Yapsor with that Winter's Curse. Envy is now here with the Spirit Siphon, but it's returning some damage due to that Blade Veil. Era will go down. Reincarnate, he is not in a good spot. There's Chronosphere, but it's not looking like they need it. Era's just going to have to sit there, take it. Going down.
A little bit of an overextension to go for that Wyvern kill, but either way, they lose three.
Yeah, just Syndrome. As I was praising them for their working together, looking coordinated, looks like I jinxed them.
Yeah, they just have to watch their positioning, very much so, especially when the Team Secret Heroes were respawning already. Luckily, they don't lose Kezu, who just picked up a gem recently.
Yeah, that's really interesting, right? We've seen Kezu pick up sometimes be picking up gems, often the blink or going for the refresher. So I imagine it will be blink and refresher. There's not really a bunch of different ways to build up this fellow. And you may be expecting, do you think the Wraith King building up a AC here while we'll see a Shiva's coming out of Timbersaw?
Maybe another item before the Shiva or before the AC. I'm trying to think of what he might want.
Why are you worried about him going for an AC so soon, needing damage?
Yeah, his right clicks aren't doing that much with the armlet and the blade mail. I mean, sure, the blade mail is not really like a damage item in the most part. It does give like 22, but it's more so obvious about the damage return. And I mean, the AC, it provides him with the armor that he does need a little bit more versus the Death Prophet. That looks like the inventory doesn't look that pretty to me for some reason. Like blink, blade mail, armlet into a AC. We'll see what he decides to do, but it's a possibility.
He's saving up. Definitely could do with some more damage. Another smoke that doesn't quite connect for Escape Gaming, and they're out for 4 minutes. Yeah, none hanging out on anybody, none on the courier, so they're gonna have to relax. But apparently their idea of a good time is pushing up onto this bottom tower.
Yep, secret smoked again. And the line is drawn.
Like, we're gonna run out of... Yeah, this is another smoke. Oh, Radiant Scan off on the wrong spot, but they have the right idea. And Arteezy will reveal he's very baity bait.
Yeah, but these guys seem to know exactly what's up right now. And especially now with the Hawk.
Oh, but Puppy, he's getting around onto the sidelines. He'll be able to blink there. Catch out Kezu, dragging him back with Envy, showing off that BKB. Kezu silenced up Syndrome, giving his life again. And with the stun, Envy has to get around this fissure. He'll kill off Syndrome, but he won't catch Kezu. And that's another BKB charge down and an exorcism.
Syndrome always throwing his life away for his buddies. Such a selfless guy.
Yeah, playing the Dazzle, playing the Venge. It's all he ever gets to do. Obviously nice to burn down that BKB, but Secret immediately capitalizing on the Exorcism being out and taken for Sean.
Yep, it's got about 5 more seconds left on Exorcism and it should be just enough time to have them clean that up, but it does look like Escape is trying to step toward them, but they don't really have the opportunity to go in right now.
All they have is an Echo Slam, but Secret very far spread apart. And there we go. Faceless Void picking up the Aegis. Does this... Oh, actually, they're going in. Error trying to work through Pylite Die. They get the quick kill. Arteezy running away. And with that, everybody else will back on out from Secret. So at least they found something.
Yeah, small little gain. It's nothing big. But still, kill's a kill.
If you're Escape, do you have to dodge fights then for another 5 minutes?
You have to just take fights on your own account. Like, you can't fight 5v5. You have to take small engagements. And this is where the Void is going to become a big, big problem for the Wraith King. He's got the Manta finished up like we were mentioning before, and now the Diffusal. So he will be able to burn through the Wraith King's mana pool.
Yeah, that's really scary coming out here for the Wraith King. But all of them staying grouped up on Escape. You know, you've got swaps at the ready if Era gets caught in a Chronosphere. Also Primal Roar to stun out Arteezy. And Puppy, he's just going to go back to farming up a storm. Do you think that's a BKB coming out from him next?
Yeah, definitely. I thought he might opt for a blade mail this game, but he's not really the damage dealer in this lineup. Maybe later on after the BKB or something, but getting the BKB is just much safer. He's the one who's going to be doing a majority of the initiations and then letting the Darkseer, Winter Wyvern, and Void do the counter initiations after he does go in.
Era, he saved up almost 3,000 gold. Incredibly rich there, but to wait a second to see what he wants to buy out. And also, they're grouping up top. It looks like Koikva and Kezu trying to put some pressure on that top tower. Oh, here comes Bulba. Never mind, they're gonna get backed on out because Envy has appeared. Who keeps buying their tomes.
Yeah, he wants his level 16 as fast as possible. And it looks like he's going to go for that build that we saw him do the other day. He buys the Talisman of Evasion and And it looks like he's probably going to build that into the solar crust that he did do the other day on the Death Prophet. So a bit outside the box, but it's something that he's done before.
And it can help against the Timbersaw, who has high armor. And of course, we're expecting Wraith King at some point to get an AC, and he also has the Blade Mail already. So, interesting pickup.
Eats both tomes, level 15 on Death Prophet, about to be level 16.
Yeah, we're similar to the scan, as we've talked about in previous casts, seeing different teams using the tomes different ways. A lot of teams allow their supports to get it. So here maybe comes the fight. Oh, Tip Koifa, he jumps forward. Will he get? No, time dilation does come out. Arteezy, of course, has the Chronosphere. He's still chasing. Yapzor is there, ready to stun. Blinks away, just staying within the fissure.
Oh,
and there
the
it is, the swap. Yeah. Cinderin giving his life. Fissure as well, just delaying things up. Puppy jumping forward, looking for something. We will see Cinderin go down here on the sidelines. Puppy does not have Blink up, and well, just Cinderin thinks.
What a guy. Oh my god, Bulba almost catches the vacuum up on Yapzor up in the trees. Almost cancels his TP. But yeah, again, Cinderin in the perfect positioning, but...
And actually allowing Koifa to put a little bit of pressure on that mid tower while all that's happening.
Yep.
So, yeah, well, we get to go back to farming as Escape managed to dodge a couple team fights. It's going to... It looks like it's the AC coming out.
Yeah. I guess it probably will be just because of that, the damage from the Death Prophet. You might as well just get it. It's just, it's going to be Mjolnir. Okay.
Oh, okay. Yeah, didn't want to say it and then, but yeah, that's damage. There we go.
Yeah. I was really questioning the AC. I don't know if it's, like, that terrible, but I like this Mjolnir pickup way more. Procs off of all the ghosts, it procs off of Iron Shell, all the, like, different damage instances, and it'll let him be that more kind of like scary frontliner.
Also gives him a way to damage Wyvern in the Cold Embrace.
Yep.
Just little things where maybe left alone want to make sure that Winter's Curse doesn't come out if Wyvern's saving herself to cast that later. So, well, we get to go back to our regularly scheduled farming because them's the rules of this patch. Bulba gonna be rocking that Blink Dagger and of course the Guardian Greaves. And as we said, MV, we're expecting the Solar Crest. Yep, Medallion coming out now. Trying to see if we've got anything particularly surprising, but wouldn't say so. Oh, no, Lotus Orb is finished on Koifa. That's really nice.
Yeah, that's to remove the time dilation off himself. Probably, that's like probably the biggest one that at least I can think about.
Yeah. Well, and Cinderin, of course, Brown Boots. He actually has an urn. That's good for him. So, what are your next moves here? Obviously, Escape need to find a way to get Envy to either blow him up before he gets off a long amount of that exorcism, and which is difficult into the BKB, or need to find a way to initiate after the exorcism.
They need to just, the way they take the fights is, it's going to be really difficult for them just because they need to play around so many different ultimates and such chaos from the side of Secret, like Vacuum Wall, Vacuum into Chrono, Vacuum into like Winter's Curse, all these different things synergize super well, so they have to just take the fights patiently, and Yapzor needs to land some pretty enormous Psycho Slams for them.
Yeah, a lot
even
of
though the game is actually quite even, it's still very hard for Escape to fight into the draft of Secret.
They're obviously, I mean, the Aegis, I believe, was just reclaimed. I'm expecting fights around this next Roshan, just because of how key it is. What are you cracking up about?
Nothing. I just glanced out. Looked at the chat and just. They're just saying, for the watch, for Cinderin, when he sacrifices his life. It's actually pretty funny.
That's pretty good.
It's a pretty good one.
So, yeah, I was going to say, I'm expecting a fight around Roshan next. I'm just, even with the Aegis, it's really hard, as you said, fighting into Exorcism and Bloody Puppy on this axe with that coal that goes through BKB. It's such a pain to deal with.
Yeah, both teams are playing very, like, kind of five-man oriented, though. Farming very close to each other. Both teams playing kind of afraid in a way.
If this has to go super late, who are you giving the edge to?
Super late? I think, I don't know. I mean,
feel free to qualify with minutes. Oh, Primal Roar going out onto Puppy. Do they have it? Yes, they do. No time to get up that extra armor. Who is coming in? The Fissure way too soon. Arteezy now with that time dilation, but Era has stunned him up. Arteezy needs some help, but they're just going to knock him down, get a Lightning Croc. It won't be. The Winter's Curse comes out. They'll kill off that creep. And now a vacuum back. Arteezy, he could open up with the Chronosphere. Era, he hasn't lost enough mana. He will reincarnate the Timber, the Chakram, causing problems for Arteezy, but they will lose Kezu, and now Era needs some help from Koikva. It is 3v2. How long on the exorcism? Oh yeah, Era, will he turn around and use it? He still hasn't used it. Finally, he pops it there, doing a lot of damage to Eternal Envy, but he just doesn't have enough, and Koikva stunned up there, unable to throw out the Chakram. Never mind, Eternal Envy exorcism ends, and she heals right back up.
Gem lost.
Oh.
And that was actually like one of the most bizarre curses. I mean, he tried to curse to like peel everybody off of him, but he ends up cursing the Book 3, and everybody targets it and kills it, and the damage gets reflected onto the Winter Wyvern when you kill your book, even with curse. So it actually ends up killing himself anyway. However, still quite a nice fight for Secret, even though they did lose that tower. They do end up gaining that gem, even though they have to expend their ultimates, but It's hard to determine really who wins this late game just because of the potential of the Hawk having given you so much vision, but and they can get a lot of like pickoffs and a lot of potential to take the fights properly for Escape Gaming, but Secret just has so many different like I was commenting before, like so many different ways of wombo combo, and the later the stages in the game go, it's when those like probably the refresher coming out for the Void eventually at one point, or maybe even the Aghanims for the extended duration of the Chrono. Octarine out for the Death Prophet eventually, so I would probably favor Secrets just because they have an easier time defending the high ground in comparison to Escape. And Escape, like we were mentioning too, Wraith King, not really the greatest sieger. He's pretty much just enabled by his Vengeant Beastmaster to be a better sieger, but other than that, he's not the best at it.
Yeah. Well, Smoke comes out. They do have Echo Slam. They have actually all the ults up that they need. See if they can find someone alone. Puppy, maybe coming over to them. Oh, walking back up. They don't have much vision out on the map. Obviously, with that gem stolen, it becomes very difficult to put down your wards. And actually, it's just going to be creeps getting a tier 2.
Kezu actually walks right through that scan that Secret does, so they walk right into their base.
Yeah. But we're not having any great smokes in this game.
No, it seems like those kind of are great smokes, but like in the opposite way. The other teams are just reading the smokes quite well.
Yeah, and I know. I think it just is about to get scarier for Escape. I imagine Envy gonna start working on an Octarine next, and then you're having to deal with Exorcism really frequently. They're already having trouble, not quite able to burst down Arteezy.
Yeah, and Yapzor is forced to buy another gem, so he buys a gem for Kezu, because Kezu did lose his in the last engagement. And Puppy's actually carrying that one.
This is the Roche fight. They're talking about Puppy. His smoke will not quite be broken.
But it does end.
Oh my gosh, Eternal Envy has maybe been caught out here. Will be put into that Cold Embrace, and immediately the Winter's Curse onto Era. I hear Primal Roar on the backlands. We're actually going onto Arteezy as well. He has no more mana. He will be able to BKB up though. Guardian Greaves making it so he can time walk away. He can't Chronosphere though. Fissure coming on through. Cinder and going down for his teammates while Eternal Envy being a pain to Era on the backlines. Reincarnate was already used. Arteezy being saved there by Cold Embrace as well. And Axe trying to get a call off, but it'll just be Cinderin. How was that team fight? Just Cinderin.
They pop the reincarnate, and Envy actually goes for a Shiva. So I like this more catch for himself, and he still needs a bit more armor. So I like that pickup a bit more than just rushing the Octarine first here. And yeah, they pop the reincarnate. He thankfully as well also got an arcane rune right before he used exorcism again.
And it's looking... Oh no, they're not going to smoke. They just wanted to Guardian Greaves together. But yeah, as you mentioned, helping Envy catch up to people more, has the Spirit Siphon slow, can do some good work with the Shivas, so...
That was very close to being a one fight for Escape, though. Just because they almost brought out Arteezy instantly, then the fight just gets kind of split up. Arrow was in the river fighting the Death Prophet while the rest of his team was just trying to burst down the Void. So maybe if they were able to get Era out of there a little bit sooner, they might have actually been able to do something and take out the Void a bit sooner.
It feels like we've seen that show before. When Escape had such trouble against Vega. It was that fight in the Verse Pit that they lost, where one fight was happening in the river and one fight happening up there. But speaking of stuff happening in the Verse Pit, all of Secret here at the ready. Puppy, of course, has Cole. The scary thing is Arteezy. Oh gosh, Puppy just jumps in, four stuffs out. And I'm not sure Eric can stand there. He'll have Reincarnate back up. Well, this is tense.
That's a scary place to fight versus a Darkseer.
Versus a Darkseer, versus a Chronosphere, like...
Oh, he surges the illusion of Arteezy. Are they gonna think that's real?
Oh my goodness, Era being Spirit Siphon immediately pops that Blade Mail Eternal Envy, taking a lot of damage. Where is the Echo Slam? Kezu, he's coming in. Primal Roar onto Puppy. Someone, no, Envy gets off his BKB. Cinderin gonna be forced to run away. Beast Monster goes down. Era has used his Reincarnate. He blinks over to the sidelines, trying to blow up Envy here. They Echo Slam just onto him. Bulba caught out as well. But there it is, the Chronosphere Era. No Reincarnate here. Do they have the damage? Koikva, no, his Chakra, it's locked. And there it is. Lotus Orb gonna, Winter's Curse gonna help them kill off Yapzor. Lotus Orb not gonna save Wraith King from going down. It's Koikva against the world. Buyback though, from Earthshaken. That should be it.
Yep, still. They are able to steal the other gems, so Puppy is a thief. He has two gems now from the enemy team. That's actually quite painful for Escape, but still, the fights are going pretty back and forth. Even though Escape loses three and is forced to use a buyback, Secret does lose two of their cores.
Yeah, it's, as you said, very painful that they lose another gem up. I believe theirs is on cooldown for a while here then. Yeah, 5 more minutes. I'm trying to figure it out. Koikva's done a really good, or figure out what Escape can do. Koikva's done a really good job of not dying, getting those Bloodstone charges up. Of course, has a Shiva's. Wouldn't be surprised if he goes for a Sheepstick next. Do you think there's something better that can help them control these teamfights?
Sheep sounds pretty good, but maybe he just goes for the Agony. Yeah, he's just gonna go for the Agony.
Oh yeah, that of course.
They're kind of just ignoring him in the fight. In the last 2 ones, they just kind of like ran away and avoided him. So now maybe this Agonyms will put a little bit of fear into their hearts, just because of how much damage potential Timbersaw is able to bust out with that.
Yeah, the time dilation's really hurting him.
Yeah.
Something he like you just can't play the way that you should on a Timbersaw. You talked about it in the draft, but short cooldown heroes really get messed up.
He even bought the Lotus Orb for himself, but he ended up using it on somebody else in that fight, and then he gets hit by the time dilation. He was just, you even said it, you were like, oh, his Timber Chain just, it's just stuck, you know, it's stuck on cooldown from the time dilation during a lot of that engagement.
He saw the Winter's Curse come out, and he threw it, I mean, he saw the animation, so he threw it on the Wraith King, thinking that was going to be the target, and unfortunately guessed wrong. It was Yapzor, actually, and, I mean, that's how it goes sometimes. I even thought it was going to be on Era, but of course it makes more sense to do it onto Yap. So either way, Roshan, everybody knows there are some Faceless Void illusions from the Manta. And Era.
Any new items picked up? Darkseer BKB. They have 2 Force Staffs on the side of Secret as well, while Escape only has the 1 Force Staff on the Earthshaker currently.
On the upside, Death Prophet's BKB is 5 seconds, 8 seconds on both the Faceless Void and Puppy. And Popper, who is traveling really, really fast there. Kezu, gonna see him in the Creepsies vacuum back though. Kezu, not looking great here for our Beastmaster, so just gonna fall.
No chop, but still dies. Puppy picks up a plate mail now too, so he might be going for a Shiva's Guard for himself, even though they already have one on Envy. I guess he might just go for the Assault Quirrus or the Lotus Orb.
Maybe finally Roshan going to go down. Solarcrest, of course, helping them smack away at it. And Escape not having a great way to contest this one. So now another 5 minutes of trying to take those incredibly careful fights or just avoid them altogether.
Yeah, the way Envy has been itemizing it like in the past couple games has been really interesting. This was something he did the other day on Death Prophet. He picked up the Solarcrest. I was talking about it before when he did pick it up, but attributing to his game earlier when he was playing Terrorblade as well, he brought in a Hurricane Pike just to deal with the specific like Razor counter. So he's always just very clever with the way he does his item builds, and it's working out for him right now.
Well, we get to go back to that farming game.
It's just these team fights. It's all about the team fight execution now at this point.
Yeah.
And the good thing for Secret is that they have the dire advantage, so they're able to claim that Roshan. Not only because of that, obviously, it was attributed to the many engagements that was happening around the pit, but it does help them a little bit.
And it does also just feel like they have, as we've talked about, the easier lineup to execute. once you know, you know, you fight with exorcism, and when it's off, you try to back on out. Not try, you do. On the good news for Escape Beastmaster, making some progress on that refresher.
Yeah, he's getting pretty close. Dire gets a nice scan. They know that Escape are sitting on their high ground now.
Do you try and defend this tier 2? It seems like a death wish for Escape.
You can just, you kind of have to linger around. You can't really go push out lanes. You're kind of afraid at this point. So, not really defend, but just kind of chill and see what's going to happen and see if maybe Secret makes a big mistake.
Oh, TZ, standing in the middle of a creep wave. It's just going to be double Chakram, making sure to burn those down. Syndrome, I'm waiting for the Chronosphere and the Syndrome save. It's all we live for here.
Yeah. He's very good at being that, you know, that sacrificial lamb.
Ping's coming out onto Eternal Envy. Cold Embrace now on TZ. This tower's very low. Not sure.
Yeah, it's a great game though for Secret. They have both of their lanes pushing in heavily onto Escape Gaming's side, and they are pressuring as well, so Escape has no place to farm right now, and they have to just kind of sit there and watch their tower die.
Yeah, and that of course reflected in the net worth, steadily trending down towards Secret, the experience as well, and it looks like Secret on their way to get another tier 2, unless Escape do something. And yeah, Timber ends up getting a blink as this last item. He's got bots as well, just I understand it'll put them into some good positions, but like you talked about, if they don't get rid of that time dilation on him...
He's just gotta save the Lotus Orb for himself, pretty much exclusively.
Well, time to learn to be selfish.
Yeah.
And Quickbit doing a good job cutting some creeps, pushing things out.
Yeah, he found his way out of the base to cut those creep waves. Now he's gonna clear this neutral camp, probably go top, cut the wave as well, if he sees that he has enough time.
Well, Envy holding that exorcism for the base on high ground defenses. Escape, they have some good stuff, obviously, with the Timbersaw, the Earthshaker, with the Echo Slam, and a Primal Roar. Do you think it's enough here?
I mean, not really. Like, they have to... you can tell, like, Escape is in a really weird position for themselves. They can't really take straight-up engagements. Like, the way... Their ease of taking engagements is... so much harder than Secret's. Secret has like a bunch of different, there's like one ultimates that they can just kind of click out and catch several people in it, while Escape has a lot of the pressure on them to land pretty much perfect ultimates and perfect positioning.
Well, hard ask. So it does look like a minute, a little over a minute and a half left on that Roshan Kazu. Getting ready to walk into some people. They see him. He doesn't quite see. Oh, he's right under a water tunnel. Envy does pop that exorcism. There's going to be the BKB Kazu with the 4-star forwards and a beautiful fissure. Did they just dodge an exorcism? Wow.
Looks like they did.
That buys a good 130 seconds, and that's going to be Aegis time.
Envy does not hesitate on using his BKB or his exorcism. That's for damn sure.
Well, BKB's been at 5 for a while due to the lack of hesitating. How big of a problem is that exorcism really though? As you talked about, it feels like Secret still in the driver's seat, regardless of how late this goes.
It's scary. You don't really want to fight without it, of course. You're gonna just be able to just play a little bit more defensively, but they still have Aegis, they still have Cheese, so that's a little bit more of an advantage, and Escape is...
Oh gosh, they're looking for it right there!
Oh my god, they're all clumped up. Four-man Chrono!
He manages to hit all of them. Yapzor's gonna be brought down here. Syndra, and he can't save life this time. Quickbutt, all he can do is throw out Chakram's Error. Is somehow still alive in the middle of all of that. He's gonna reincarnate into the hell that is his new life and only buyback. Let's see. We're gonna see Error falling here very, very quickly.
He
doesn't have a buyback.
You don't want to fight without Exorcism unless you land a four-man Chrono.
Oh, yeah.
So, incredible positioning there from Artizi. Jumps and takes the opportunity. Again, even though they don't have the exorcism, they know that they can take the fight. And yeah.
And now with the time dilation, actually Timbersaw having a Dagon up there, trying to just harass people down, get them off of his tower. This is not great.
Definitely not great is right.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know a better way to express. They only have buyback on Beastmaster and Timbersaw and double Chakram. Well, it's slowing things down. More Dagons onto Ortizi, hoping to get him off of the tower. Lotus orbing away that time dilation. If it's just the tower here, I think that's actually a big win for Escape.
Exorcism's going to be up again in 25 seconds, and Puppy's also sieging the bottom lane.
Yeah, they can't catch a break on Escape.
These double chakrams, though.
Yeah.
Clearing that the wave so quickly, clearing out catapults as well, super fast.
How do you feel in the game where Escape were playing against Vega? We did feel that Koikba on the Invoker had very little impact. Obviously, Timbersaw a bit of a different beast, but again, we've mentioned that Secret has been somewhat ignoring him in fights. He's usually been a bit further away from the group. Do you think getting a more utility hero instead of this block pick?
No, I think that the Timber's doing fine. It's just Secret's playing really well around it. It's not really like on Koikba so much, just the Secret itemized to be able to deal with it, having those, like, what, 1, 2, 3 BKBs, 4 BKBs now with, yeah, 4 BKBs up on their cores pretty much, so he struggles to find the opportunities to bring people down, and, I mean, it's not really his fault, he just has to find better chances, but they don't really have a Chronosphere or anything along those lines for him to get, like, the extended lockdown. They only have a Beastmaster Roar and some Earthshaker follow-up. Yeah. And Venge is, Sin's not really able to do much in this game anymore. He's just, like we've been saying, the sacrificial lamb. He's 0-10 and 7. Doesn't really represent the impact that he's been having on the game, but still, he doesn't really contribute a whole lot to the fights. He's just, you know, he's a Venge. He's his aura, he's some terror, a few terrors, a few stuns, and then, of course, that swap out if he's in the proper position.
Yeah. Well, for Escape, they're going to find a DD. That's something we haven't touched on Era in a while. It actually hasn't had item progress in... That's a fresh BKB, but...
Yeah, he had it the last fight too, but...
He didn't use it.
Yeah, he's not even really able to get it off. Like, he just gets comboed down by those... The Chronosphere, especially.
He has a DDD. They're not going to make a jump for it. And Daya uses the scan. We'll see that nobody's walking over there. So is this a smoke gathering coming out here? There is one available on the Wyvern. Might smoke up the four in the back and attempt to bait Puppy.
Yep, they have top lane pushing in heavily, mid lane pushing in quite heavily, so they could use this as their opportunity to go. And Envy actually goes for a heart instead of the Octarine or anything, so he just wants to become this super tanky frontliner, and just, he just doesn't really care about having the Octarine.
Yeah, it is something we have a lot of trouble. We've seen they can't take down the Death Prophet, so... Adding some health, and Secret will check in on Roshan, see if it's coming up soon. Is there other ways that Escape can try to play this? Can they possibly get some split push going with Kezu? It just feels like the option of fighting not working.
They can, but they're at risk. You know, every time if they split push past the river, they're at risk of dying every single time to pretty much any of the ultimates from Secret. Even if they're one person, they'll throw an ultimate for one person for sure if they're past the river.
Oh.
But... Yeah, looks like Secret's picking up some more small items, waiting for that Roshan to respawn and gonna take it again. Envy's still sitting on that cheese. Mid lane.
Now this is extra scary, right? The fact that Envy can just be getting low, pop all the way back up to that 3,200 health.
Yeah, the heart pickup is also interesting because they're having a hard time, like we've been saying. They're kind of like the Secret lineup is kind of dancing around Escape's lineup as long as they don't, unless they land like a huge Chronosphere. And if he's dancing around with a heart, and the heart gets, you know, reapplied, it just starts healing him in the middle of the engagement if he's in good positioning and if he's kiting the Wraith King properly.
Yeah. Well. Is that another gem on Kezu? Or
yep.
Is that... Yeah. Okay. Well, they've had to keep a lot of those. Checking out buyback status this time. We will see it up on Era. Also Timbersaw, but that's it for their side of the map. So, a bad Chronosphere here. Gonna cause a lot of problems. Any smokes? Nope. Oh gosh, it kind of comes down to whoever blinks first.
Yeah, and just taking a look at the net worth, you can see pretty much from where that 42 minute point on, it's been the Secret pretty much quite dominant since that point on.
Okay, Koikba again going to be the bait. Syndrome trying to stay up there in range so that he can be ready for swap at any moment, but they don't take the bait. They go for Roshan on Secret, and they have to know about this on Escape. If they can't contest this, they're going to have a lot of problems, but unfortunately Secret has wards all up in their jungle.
They're going to fake it, yep. I knew they were going to do this one too.
Oh.
Like, they're going to go for the fake play. They have a ward up. They have vision of some of the heroes on Escape Gaming. And they do not expect this at all. They don't see it.
Okay,
and they get a two. Oh,
no!
he
stomped randomly for the creep. Oh, and now the fissure. They don't manage to vacuum Kezu back over the wall. The swap as well. Cinderin running to make sure he saves their life. Bulba's already activated his BKB. Cinderin will go down there. And Bulba looking for some more. Koikva in a little bit of trouble is there. The Chronosphere catches two of them. Era's on the edge as well. They need some help. The BKB is no longer. Era gonna get beaten up by Kezu. Koikva getting very, very low here. He needs some help from his teammates. He throws out the chopper. Timber Team over to the sidelines, but Ortiz just ends up following him, bashing him in that time log. It doesn't matter about your Lotus Orb. They will see Timber Soul go down. He immediately buys back Eternal Envy in that cold embrace with the Echo Slam onto all of the creeps coming out there. But Envy eats the cheese up, and Era, he is fighting someone who is just much, much bigger than him. Era does have Reincarnate here. Kezu getting low. Puppy, they need to dagger him down. They managed to. Era with the Lotus Orb and the Blade Mail coming out here. We'll see whether he can fight into Envy. Timber Soul trying to help him with both of those chakrams and be unable to get full stuffed up to the high ground. And they will lose the first life. Going for jumping in. This is his second life. If he goes down into the exorcism, that's going to be a dieback. They need some help. And Era swapped out here by Cinderin and Arteezy being smacked up. No, they can't quite do it. They stun him again. The lightning, its procs are not enough. And Era will fall. He buys back this team fight. There are a lot of buybacks on escape. We'll have to see if it ever ends. They still haven't lost a Rax.
Recovering both gems. They're like, oh, even more gems from Kezu. Thank you.
Oh my goodness. So that's three gems now up on Secret.
Yeah. And now Secret or Arteezy finishes up the AC as well to counteract theirs, and Envy grabs himself his veil back off the courier, which he'll probably be getting rid of soon. But man, Envy's build is actually owning so hard. Like, Era's like hitting him and he's doing zero damage. Even when he crits, it was like, it said 700, but it did a lot less than that. And the Solo Crest of Vision is paying off dividends.
Yeah, I'm not sure how they kill Envy now. Obviously, it would have helped if he didn't have that cheese, but he's about to have another one. So.
Yeah, it's just so many different forms for them to, so many different big teamfight ultimates just for Secret, and it's looking to work very well for them. That was pretty hilarious, though, the Enchant Totem from Yapzor. He's like, I'm going to farm this I caught the Naxx with my stun. That was very cheeky, but.
Yeah. Oh, no. And they smoke right under wards.
Yep. So Secret will be prepped for this one. Either go on, they'll probably just go on their base. They don't need to risk anything outside of it.
Huh. Escape gonna fail this smoke. What other options do they have? They've got some smokes up. They don't have any. Oh, sorry. They've got no smokes up. None in their inventory either. Kezu put way back on that refresher due to the buyout.
Yeah. And everyone on the side of Secret is farming while on Escape. It's pretty much only the Timber Saw now at this rate. Wraith King is finding very little bits. His item progression has pretty much halted, as you mentioned.
Yeah, Escape, they're 20,000 net worth behind. Oh gosh, Cinderin, you will get cold. Put into a bit of trouble there. Puppy actually acting like he's looking for more, but instead we'll just pick off the Venge. It doesn't feel like Escape's lineup is one of those that can do anything much being 20,000 net worth behind.
Yeah.
Especially with the Death Prophet rocking so much health.
Yeah, they're trying, but the Wraith King's just getting, he's getting kited around way too hard.
Well, maybe wishing they'd pick something else up, but they have to go for this hold. It is going to be MKB. Wraith King desperately needing that due to this Solar Crest. There, double chakram, just trying to get rid of the creep waves, but Arteezy coming into the base, starting to make quick work of the melee rack.
He hits fast.
Oh my goodness, they will land the fissure on him.
Yes.
Oh gosh, it's just going to be racks going down. Arteezy, he's finished the job, uses time walk pretty much in place, Lotus Orb going out onto him as well, so that there can't be such easy stuns or swaps, and yeah, he backs out.
He hits very hard though. 200 agility up on that void. With an AC as well. And he has money for Moonshard if he wants to. Or if he wants to maybe get new defusal charges or just replace that item as a whole.
Yeah, he can help with team with wards. Everything under the sun. This is...
Not quite yet.
We're approaching 30,000 net worth. We are at a 30,000 experience lead for Team Secret.
Yep, drawing the line. They do not want to pass that point. It seems like Cinderin's just like, guys, this is the line. This is the line that we do not cross. Listen to me. Thank you. And they listened. They all ran back.
Do you think there's much Sindarin and the Earthshaker can do, item progression wise, that could actually help out here? Obviously something within their reach. It just
they're
maybe
not
a glimmer cape.
They're not really getting any money at this point anymore.
Yeah.
Yapzor's been building. He's had Blink 4 staff for 30 minutes, 20 something minutes at least, and he's been trying to build toward that Yules for quite a while, but it's just not happening. And Sindarin has unfortunately been stuck on the exact same items his entire time. Luckily now though, he has Quakefoot to buy him 16 wards.
What a guy.
And now, as we were mentioning, Envy does sell off his Veil of Discord, and now he's finally bringing out that Octarine Core as his final item.
Only took him a couple of years.
Oh. He dropped his boots of travel instead of getting rid of the cheese. Okay, cool.
I can understand that.
Yeah, that's fine.
So, Arteezy just uses Time Walk to get rid of it, and again he attacks so incredibly fast with this butterfly. With the Manta and the Diffusal Blade. Okay, Kezu with the Primal Roar onto Arteezy. They're trying to burn some of his mana, but a nice pull by Puppy, bringing folks back. Arteezy, they'll bring him down. A godlike streak has been ended. Puppy, though, standing there in the BKB era, is just trying to smack people around now, desperately trying to get away from Eternal Envy. Beastmaster already fallen. Era being pulled back there by Puppy and Era. Life number one, it's not quite dead yet. Finally, he'll go down. Arteezy coming back into the team fight with the buyback. He wants to end this game. He wants to end it now. Koiksa getting called back, but the Beautiful Echoes left coming out of Yapzor. Quickfoot manages to get into the fountain. Yapzor is trapped by own fissure. And Era not quite able to kill off Arteezy. He is not looking good. The spirits won't chase him into the fountain. But that is Rax in another lane. Eternal Envy just going to turn around on it once the glyph is down. And there we go. Secret. Two lanes of business.
Nice play from Escape, though, to at least bring down the Void once, forcing Arteezy's buyback to come in, but still, it's looking like it's coming just a little bit too late, and the side of Secret is just way too strong. With the 30,000 net worth lead, and with that Death Prophet, just being able to siege so easily, yeah, it's just becoming very, very hard for them. And getting anything, like, getting the Void at least was kind of nice, but still, yeah, just instant buyback, boots of travel into the fight.
Yeah, on the upside, it's nice that they have a Mjolnir against supers in two lanes, but it's not where you want to be. 30,000 net worth deficit now, and 30,000 experience apparently just stops down here. Can't get worse.
Yeah, they're like all level 25 on the side of Secret for the most part now. Bulba and Pi are like level 18 and 20 respectively.
Yeah. Oh. Okay, so now, how do you lure if you're Escape Secret into your fountain? Because that's about where we are, it feels.
Yeah, it feels very hard for Escape to win fights. And maybe if they do that same combo that they just did on Arteezy and get lucky again and burst him down, but still, it's very hard for them to really do that in multiple different situations. It just didn't seem like Secret was super prepped there. They didn't have the Lotus Orb ready on Arteezy or anything, and they didn't have Pi in the proper position. It's just instantly Cold Embrace.
Even if Escape do manage to win a team fight, they don't push so great is the other issue. Right?
Yeah, that's what we were kind of saying earlier on.
And now it's really potent because there's no good chance of we won a team fight, let's YOLO down middle.
And for Secret, it's like every time that they do win a team fight, they have that, you know, they have an objective taker. They have the Death Prophet, as we were mentioning during the draft. So not only do they have that, but majority of the time, these fights are being taken on Escape Gaming's side of the map. So it's pretty much just a pure gain for Secret. It's like even if Escape wins like those fights, they have nothing to gain out of it. And meanwhile, Secret, if they win the fights, they have everything to gain out of it. They have push and they have just suffocating Escape Gaming by keeping all three lanes pushed in.
Well, Era can pick up bots, maybe eventually get, instead of an omelet, some other type of damage item that's a bit more expensive, or heart, so on, whatever he's really into there. I'm just trying to think. I mean, they do have some gold on Era, taking a look around. Oh, actually, it's Timbersaw, who's ridiculously rich.
Yeah, he's been buying the wards out for his team. He bought that whole Dagon 5 instead of having the Blink Dagger quite a while ago. Yeah, you see all the sentry wards placed in the jungle and give them all to Sindarin.
Do you think that the Dagon 5 is doing more work than basically a sheep, something to lock down Envy or Faceless Void?
Yeah, they need some more burst. I mean, the Hex, it doesn't seem like it'll really be like the cherry on top to help them win a fight. It's the Dagon seems to be putting a little bit more work in just to burst down the void.
Especially with Axe having a Lotus Orb.
Yeah, they can just remove the hexes now at this point really easily.
So, and, Puppy continuing to farm. Oof. I mean, they can clear out the waves here on escape, but whether they can kill anyone, they're going for a smoke.
Yeah, they're trying to gain something out of it, but Secret, very well aware of this, it seems. They are positioned completely in their base, and now we even have a Lincoln Sphere coming out for Pylai Dai, so that will be the Lincolns and the Lotus Orb being able to place on either... Actually, they've what? Wait, they've double Lincolns. Yeah, they have Bulba Lincolns, and they have Pylai Dai's, and the Lotus Orb on top as well on Puppy, so it's going to be really hard for them... for Escape to really do anything with all these single target lockdowns like the Beastmaster Roar, the Enchsta, and this, the Skeleton King, I keep saying. The Wraith King stun as well. And yeah, so the Hex pickup would pretty much be negligible at this point if the Timbersaw did go for that.
Well, we've talked enough about the dreary subject that is Escape's chances left in this match.
Yeah.
What should Secret be doing to seal this out? Roche does respawn, Puppy, rich as anything. Some other items that they can pick up on Secret to just secure this, or is it just Roche? It's somewhat inevitable.
Items are all, for the most part, luxury now on Secret. Items, at least, aren't really going to dictate the way the fights are going now. It's they already have more than enough, more than the core items that they need to take the engagements, and it's just really hard for Escape to take a proper fight. Like I was mentioning, the ease of execution for Secret is there. They just have to pretty much... Everyone has to click their R buttons in a proper manner. As long as they don't, like, chrono their whole team or something inside, like, that's like the only way that they could be messing up their ultimates now at this point. And yeah, with the gold advantage as well, it makes it much easier too.
Yeah, it's well, it's a hard one to say the least. And we know that Roche is up on the Dire. They were smoking out, seeing if they couldn't find something in this jungle. It's that fake out. Oh. Yapzor.
DD Void.
Oh, he throws it. They see the fissure. They're going to go for it. There's the pull stop, but he gets out of Puppy's way. Yapzor is getting so lucky in this area.
Really is. And yeah, though, they're just clicking through everybody. Everybody is like super farmed. And DD RTZ now, too. I mean, that's going to happen at the 70-minute mark. But DD RTZ, they're going to take down this Roshan yet again. Aegis and Cheese one more time.
Now, if Secret do win this, they have to play the other team, right?
Or... They have to play versus Fantastic Five as well. Yes.
Do we know how if all teams beat each other, do we know how it's being decided?
I'm a noob. I'm not too sure.
Excellent. As you guys hear, Fog is a noob, so we're not sure.
Yeah, that's not my department. I'm going to go ahead and blame I'll blame David.
The production, yeah. Blame yeah, let's blame David, actually.
Why not?
Sounds good.
Timbersaw gets rid of the Lotus Orb that he's had for a while now and picks up the Octarine. He realizes he needs a real tier 5 item, and there's
but
rapier.
I'm not sure it's enough. Like, okay, well, we're giving it a try.
They obviously need to do something. They're just They're just losing this game.
Exactly.
So you know what?
Lose the game slowly or lose the game fast. You're right.
You know what? I'm perfectly fine with this rapier pickup. He needs to. Like, that's the only way they win is if he gets some, like, humongous crits and just kill somebody. So, see if it's going to pay off for them. Secret's looking to close out this game, though, heading towards that top tower. Moonshard eaten on Arteezy, and
oh my goodness.
God. All right.
Okay, so I was wrong. Arteezy going to time walk away, and the Aegis deleted from the game.
See, now maybe a Hex instead of the Dagon 5, because they have a rapier on their... on their Wraith King, but...
That was shocking. Okay, guys, well, Rapier Gaming, it is up. Wraith King doesn't really have slots to get more.
They were probably so surprised by that, honestly. RT's probably like, what? I'm dead, guys. Like, I'm dead. Don't really know what happened, but I am dead.
I mean, both of us are shocked. What was he, 5-shot RTZ?
Yeah.
Maybe less.
And he has 45 armor or something, so that was pretty absurd.
Yeah, welcome to Agi Heroes. Well... maybe Secret will try to go in the front door. They still have Cheese up on Puppy, holding it here because Death Prophet has her other Cheese. Goodness gracious, they're stacked. They have still some good control. Syndrome can try to make sure that he swaps Era away from danger. There's, of course, that Reincarnate. It's not the worst place to have a Rapier.
No, definitely not. And they are keeping Secret at bay for the time being, but Secret is just waiting for all those lanes to push in.
Yeah, we actually made a horrible mistake. Clearly, going for the rapier has just delayed this till the next Roche. So, we're going to be waiting.
Might be possible. They might just be waiting for an opportunity. But yeah, they're just waiting for the side lanes to push in at first, though. But still, yeah, it's... That rapier pickup is actually scaring Secret a bit.
Era, he's gonna be spotted here by the ward. They know where he is. Era, what are you doing? Are you bait or something? Where's the swap? We need Cinderin here. Calling Cinderin. Era being brought back by Puppy. Now Spirit Siphon causing a lot of trouble. Kazu with the Lincoln Sphere. Oh no. He didn't get off the Primal Roar. Eternal Envy has a Lotus Orb up, causing a lot of problems there for Cinderin. Beast Monster dies on one side of the fight. Cinderin inevitably gonna go down there. Cold Embrace gonna save up Puppy. And oh no. I'm not sure what Arrow was thinking.
Yeah, he was really far out. I guess he thought that maybe Secret had backed up, but they did not, and Roar was expended on the Lincolns. He tried to refresh and Roar again, but he died before doing so, and they do not have buyback on either of those heroes.
Well, we're about to learn whether Escape can hold against Soup Mega Creeps. Era gonna try to go in. Spirit Siphon coming out. Oh no, Puppy with the Cole. Putting Era into a bad position. Brings him back into the Chronosphere. Thank you, Cole. There's the Shivas coming out. Era will go down once. He's gonna reincarnate here, but he needs some serious help, and he is not getting it. Echo Slam coming out from Yapzo. Is it the control they need? They will turn around the Cold Embrace, and no, the Winter's Curse. Era killing his friends. He is down. Rapier on the ground. And GG's most likely. Koifa gonna try to fight as best he can. Escape know that this is their TI dream right here, but Koifa getting blown up, head chopped off, and GG's are called.
Wow. It just seems like Escape just weren't able to fight ever. Like, they had a few small engagements and stuff that went into their favor, but it was never like, you never saw all five on Secret Day. You never saw like four heroes dead on Secret. It was always like 3-for-3 or 3-for-2 or something along those lines. And really well played by Secret, picking a massive teamfight lineup. And yeah, I mean, it works out for them, of course.
Yeah, nice draft there by Secret. Now it's their turn to go into...